What's up, guys? Switch Whispers here. We're whispering to a Wii U this time. As you can see, I've already got it taken apart. We're looking at these two fuses here, CM9, CM10. This is a known issue that people think it's the disk drive because the error code is 160-1400. Says that the disk drive can't be detected. So all you need to do for this one is we're going to take a look at these two fuses, and the fuse, how it works is it allows a certain amount of current to pass through, so it needs to pass through, meaning we need continuity. So we get our probes diode mode so that we have the beep, and we test the points. That's continuous. That's continuous. That is not continuous. I've got no beep right here or right here. Oh, we do have one there. We don't have one here. So this side of the fuse, not working. So all we have to do for this is pretty easy. And this is something I've done several times, fixed several times. The only one I haven't fixed, I had an issue in both fuses, and I replaced both fuses with just wire. So you just, you know, you take the fuse off and we're just gonna put a jumper wire from there to there, and I replaced both, and that one worked for a little while, stopped working. But if it's just one of the fuses, whether it's CM10 or CM9, just one of them, every time you take it off and you just put jumper wires, it fixes this issue and it doesn't come back with any problems. So we're just going to take this fuse off and we're going to put some jumpers and good to go. My last video was really long, so this one's gonna be nice and short. I mean, it's not a very tough repair either way. I would say this was one of my first repairs. And as you can see, I don't even take it out of its sort of metal enclosure. I just lean this top part off and we get access here. So just so you guys can see, right, I just kind of sandwich it off a little bit to give me access right near the plug-in for the disk drive. Get it back to where it was. Okay, so now quick prep. Let's get this back on. These are very common issues. I've been brainstorming to do a giveaway for my fans. And I think what we can do is have you guys, you could send me a console. And maybe we'll do Wii U. because as you can see, it's such an easy repair. So if you got a broken Wii U and you want this fixed, then like, comment, sub, and we'll do a giveaway at some point and we'll fix your Wii U. Okay, so I'm getting my jumper here. I like this stuff, it's a little bit thicker. It's out of network cable. So just like your regular Cat 5, Cat 6 network cable. It'll have this guy inside. There's the wire. And look at all those pairs. So many free jumpers. I'm just trying to make sure this holds. So I'm gonna get a little bit extra here. Just make sure that's on there. Yeah, that's pretty solid. You just want a little bit like that and chop it. And then make sure it has continuity, which it should. I mean, it's a wire. We didn't have any issue with that. There we go. Try to do this with the tweezers. I think that's good. Yeah. Solid. Oh. We'll double check that it's solid after. Oh no, not solid there. Let's give it some more flux. I mean, the only thing with this is when you don't take the case off, you got a little bit of impairment in your work. But it's okay. There. That's much nicer. Make sure you don't melt this clip like I did. It's okay though. Just touched it, grazed it. Now that looks solid. Clean it. And we'll check both for continuity. But when you test this and you notice that you don't have continuity on any of these four, because there's four traces going through technically. If any of those are not continuous, whether it's the whole fuse or just one of the lines, you know it's this is the issue. It's not the disk drive. You don't ever have to replace the disk drive in these. Like, it's not a very common thing to go. Let's get it really nice and clean. Good. Okay, that's it. That's a quick one. So we'll test it. And we'll put it back together. And we'll see you guys in the next video. That's it. Those are happy sounds. We just need to put on some solder mask to make sure this doesn't get damaged, although it shouldn't. It's inside the console. But it's always best practice to cover up any open wires. Okay. And you can always just replace this fuse, but this works, so there's no need. Okay. So now we get the UV mask. This cures pretty quick, but sometimes if you just give it just a bit of heat, it cures a bit faster. Not too much. That's it. We're all masked up for this one, guys. We'll catch you in the next video. And again, please like, comment, subscribe.